Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Armin, and in this video, I would like to show you how to model a steady-state impeller in water. Model consists of a propeller and two domains. Okay, I am gonna start modeling. To reduce the solution time, I will use the 2D model. I'm going to choose the rotating machinery fluid flow. The Reynolds number is high, so I'm going to choose K epsilon model. Frozen rotor or MRF is used for steady state solution. This model has two domains, rotating and stationary. In the end, I'm going to click on Done. First, I'm going to create a relatively large rectangular domain in the center of the page. This is my stationary domain. Then, I'm going to create a circle in the center of rectangle. I have to subtract the stationary domain from the rotating domain. The two domains must be separate. Now, I need two rectangles as impeller. Then, I'm going to subtract them from the rotary domain. It's time to subtract the impeller from the rotary domain. The two domains must be paired, so I'm going to change from a union to from an assembly. As you can see, the paired boundaries are defined. First, I want to model the impeller in a static environment. Therefore, I'm going to define output boundary condition for all edges. Only impeller rotates, so I'm going to unselect rectangle. Material is liquid water. As you see, only impeller surfaces are wall boundary conditions. I need a fine mesh to capture the fluid properties correctly. Rotating domain axis is in the center of the geometry. Finally, I'm going to click on Compute. Okay. This is velocity plot of the rotating impeller in water. I want to add an arrow streamline and velocity plot. I'm going to increase the point and add the arrow line. Now, we can see the rotation direction of flow. Now it's time to add the input velocity. Velocity magnitude is optional. Okay. You see the velocity plot with the presence of inlet flow. Thank you for taking the time to watch the entire video. Please let me know if you have any further questions.